How can people educate themselves on these particular techniques of action in order to help make their living space more self-sufficient?
Not only is there lots of people that are learning about these matters, but are actually developing the skills to share them. The best way I found about staying up with what is going on is to participate in community groups that are engaged in common cause. We have in Toronto a group called the Coalition for a Green Economy, for example, in which people come together and exchange their experiences, their skill sets, and devise means of livelihood that support the proposition of a regenerative form of commerce.
Well, it seems there's a recurring theme that keeps being brought up by yourself, and I believe I've brought it up previously as well. It's the aspect of human interaction in community. Could a small number of people make a great impact if they were to form a group that were looking towards enhancing their self-sufficiency? Is there greater impact in larger numbers, or can it start from a small nucleus?
Inevitably, it'll start with a small nucleus, but it can very quickly grow. A project that began in our offices 7 years ago was to try to create a large wind turbine that would be owned by the community as a co-op. We gathered a group of people who had a sincere interest in seeing such a proposition go forward, and despite many barriers that were placed by the community at large, it now is a celebrated event in the city that we have a large wind turbine on our waterfront. And a turbine is owned by a large number of people in the community.
Are they accessing power directly from that windmill?
They're sharing of the proceeds that are garnered by selling it into the grid. So in effect, they are producing green electrons for themselves, but it isn't directly connected to their homes. It's using the wires that are already in place.
Well, in the example of the home that actually exists here on Amherst Island that has its self-sufficiency of power through a small wind turbine, would it be advisable perhaps for people of urban centers who've got the facilities to invest themselves in a small wind turbine, would it pay off for them eventually to do this?
There are things that are appropriate at small scales and some that are better at large scales. Wind turbines tend to be much more economic in large scale. One reason is that you need to get way up high to capture the good winds. Not all places are good places to harvest wind. Whereas solar collectors, either for heating your hot water or producing electricity, it's available wherever sunlight falls. So on your homes, people are already beginning to deploy these technologies, and they deliver their heating and electricity straight to the home. I'd like to see those kind of industries morph into community-owned enterprises so that the jobs of producing them and installing them and maintaining them are part and parcel of the livelihoods of our communities.